afternoon and welcome everybody to Mr. CCH Secret Agent. We're so excited you guys are here. We're your hosts. My name's Anna. I'm a junior, and I'm a nursing major here at the university.
Hey y'all, I'm Kaylee Lauer, and I'm a senior agricultural education major here at the university, and we're so glad you guys joined us. We're going to go ahead and kick off with the judges. So I'd like to introduce you to our first judge. Claire Hawkins is a freshman from Green Valley, Missouri. She's studying biochemistry, and her talents, she cannot ride a bike. That's okay, neither can I. She drinks 2 gallons of milk every, she drinks 1 gallon of milk every 2 days, and she peaked in middle school.
Our next judge for this evening is Nora Pierce. She is a sophomore from Columbia, Missouri. Her major is food science, and a fun fact about her is that she hasn't been to the grocery store in 2 months.
Our third judge for this afternoon is Jordan Miller from Carthage, Missouri. Jordan is a junior studying psychology and will be studying abroad.
And then our final judge for this evening is Grace Stotler. She is a senior majoring in psychology and biology. And a fun fact about her is she has pet slugs. She assures that they're cute, not weird. All right, so without further ado, our boys have a show for you.
Take life, do you scent of the pine. You know how I feel. It's a new dawn. It's a new day. It's a new life. It's a new life for me. And I'm feeling good.
Did you see that dancing? I didn't know our guys could dance. Did you see those high kicks?
I know. I feel like some of them could have joined the Golden Girls team.
I don't know if they're that good. Maybe not yet.
Yeah, I don't think so.
Next up, we have our talent portion of the evening. So as our guys are getting ready, we are going to get ready to introduce all of the awards that we have going on tonight.
So first up is Mr. Legit. Mr. Legit is the talent judged by our judges.
Mr. Swag is best formal wear.
Mr. Congeniality is voted on by the guys during intermission.
And then Mr. People's Choice is the people's vote that you will get to do at intermission.
And then our overall winner will be Mr. CCH.
Which is why you're all here.
Okay, let's go ahead and introduce our first agent this afternoon. Dane Bradley Bishop is a freshman undecided major. That is confirmed. He is undecided. He is from O'Fallon, Missouri. He will be playing piano and singing. Let's go ahead and introduce Mr. Bradley D. That's his middle name, by the way, in case you guys were confused like we were.
All right, we're ready. So stick around. We're gonna hear electric music, solid walls of sound. Sir Kenny, Roni, have you seen them yet? Ooh, the soul was based out. Penny in the tits. Oh, so weird and wonderful. Oh, Benny, she's a really keen. She's got electric boots. I'm OSO. You know, I read it in a magazine. Benny in the tits. Kids plug into the veilless. Maybe they're blind. A Benny makes them ageless. We shall survive. Let us take ourselves along. Where we fight our parents out in the streets to find who's right and who's wrong. Sir Kenny Roney, have you seen them yet? Oh, the soul is based out. Penny in the chest. Oh, so weird and wonderful. Oh, Benny, she's a really keen. She's got electric boots. I'm OSO. You know, I read it in a magazine. Benny in the tits. Yeah. Kenny Roney, have you seen that yet? Ooh, the soul is based out. Penny in the chits. Oh, so weird and wonderful. Oh, Benny, she's a really keen. She's got electric boots. I'm always so, you know, I read it in a magazine.
Surely after that performance, he'll be off the chart in a few months. Let's go ahead and give it up for Mr. Bradley D one more time.
Our next secret agent is James Calandro. He's a senior studying mechanical engineering, and he's from Joplin, Missouri. Join me in welcoming Mr. Full Send.
So I did a video for this year's talent, and yeah, I guess we'll just queue up and play it. So hope y'all enjoy.
So this video is officially due in 14 hours. That gives me hopefully just enough time to showcase 14 talents, skills, or stunts that I'll be able to perform.
The first of this random montage of stunts is surfing.
So I've actually surfed once before using a board in Georgia I borrowed from an employee at a surf shop who let us sleep on our apartment floor after hearing we slept in a church parking lot on the beach in a cemetery in Adam Middle School before getting a ticket for squatting.
Here's me doing the best I can to surf in Missouri.
Your lock screen. That's your reason to keep going.
Yeah. band is pretty cool. I'll vote for him.
Let's give it up for Mr. Folsom and Moon Choi.
I'm looking forward to seeing him in an ER near me very soon.
Our next suspect agent for this afternoon is Sam Cote. Sam is a senior nursing major from Liberty, Missouri. Let's go ahead and welcome Mr. Marvel to the stage as he sings.
Get down to business to defeat the Huns. Did they send me daughters when I asked for sons? You're the saddest bunch I've ever met, but you can bet before we're through, Mr. I'll make a man out of you. Tranquil as a forest, but a fire within. Once you find your center, you are sure to win. You're a spineless, pale, pathetic lot, and you haven't got a clue. Somehow I'll make a man out of you. I'm never gonna catch my breath, say goodbye to those who knew me. Why was I fooling fool for cutting gym? This guy's got me scared to death, hoping he'd see right through me. Now I realize that I knew how to swim. Be a man, we must be swift as a coursing river, with all the strength of a great typhoon. With all the strength of a raging fire, mysterious as the dark side of the moon. Time is racing toward us till the Huns arrive. Heed my every order, and you might survive. Suited for the rage of war, so pack up, go home, you're through. How could I make a man out of you? We must be swift as a coursing river, with all the force of a great typhoon, with all the strength of a raging fire, mysterious as the dark side of the moon. We must be swift as a coursing river, with all the force of a great typhoon, with all the strength of a raging fire, mysterious as the dark side of the moon.
Man, I really hope that Mr. CCH makes a men out of some of those boys back there.
That's a little too hopeful.
I know.
Our next agent is Mr. Nothing, Yusuf Francis. He's a senior with a civil engineering major, and he has a talk for us.
Now, when I first considered what I would be doing for Mr. CCH, I thought very deeply about it. And after much deliberation and consideration, I came up empty. I had nothing. So that's what I decided to do. I'm Mr. Nothing, and that's what I'm going to present to you here today at Mr. CCH. I have nothing groundbreaking, nothing inspirational, nothing even remotely interesting at all. However, through my manner of speaking, I will make it seem like I do. To begin, I'm going to make a lot of hands gestures. I'm going to do this with my left hand. I'm going to do this with my right hand. I'm going to look at the audience, and I'm going to adjust my glasses. First, I'm going to ask you all a question. By show of hands, how many have been asked that question before? Thank you. It's amazing. Next, I'm going to tell a personal story. Something endearing to break the tension and create a personal connection. Maybe something a little embarrassing. And all of you guys are going to say, aw. Thank you. It really happened. Now, I'm going to bring you back in. I'm going to make it intellectual. I'm going to bring it to this man right here. Now, what this man did was great, I'm sure. But I, for one, have no idea who he is. I just Google searched the word important scientist. Now, I would like you to think what I'm saying is important and interesting. However, what I'm really doing is just me buying time. Now, let's look at the numbers. The number of presentations that I'm giving here today, well, that's going to be one. The amount of talents present in said presentation, that's going to be zero. My height in inches while wearing boots is 70.5. Please note the 0.5. 1 plus 2 is equal to 3. And interestingly enough, 2 plus 1 is also equal to 3. That's math. Y is equal to mx plus b. A squared plus b squared is equal to c squared. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And closely following that, we get 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Now, and for more filler, let's take a look at some additional numbers. 5. 23. 5,401. 8.3 million. 7. 7. 27. This is staggering. These are all real numbers. Let's look at a graph. As you can see, 2 is greater than 1. 3 is greater than 2, and not only that, but 4 is less than 5. Amazing. Let's take a look at this line graph as it shows similarly irrelevant data. Now, I'm doing this to make it seem like I did my homework. Like I put effort into this and put real time into this. However, none of that is true. Now, I'm going to show you some words paired with barely thought-provoking imagery. I'm doing this to make it seem like I'm making good use of my time as well as yours, when in reality, I have no idea what half of them mean. And as these go on, I'm just going to start saying gibberish. Gabba gabba, shriveled up, hep top to the mountaintop, skip top and it's like a lap dog, Michael Jackson, LeBron James, words, phrases, objects, adjectives, and more phrases. Amazing, isn't it? Maybe if you'd watch this with the sound off, it could make me seem like a true professional. Like I have something important and interesting to say, but that's not true. But I'm growing. I wore them because I thought they made me look smart, when in reality, I'm wearing contacts. Now, I'm going to bring you in. I'm going to make it seem like I have a point, like I might reach a satisfaction. life's truly a roller coaster. Now, if there's anything that you got for my presentation, I want you to in the beginning. And I want you to think about what you're hearing right now. Because it was nothing, and it's still nothing. Think about that. And now I will stop talking.
Made it feel like there was something.
Yeah, I just feel like there was like something there. Like, what do you guys think? Raise of hands if you think there was something. There's like four people, so there was nothing, Kaylee. There was nothing.
Confirmed, there was nothing. Our next agent for this afternoon is Travis Franks. Travis is from Columbia, Missouri, and is currently studying personal financial planning. He's a sophomore and today starring as Mr. Dream in a Cardigan.
Hello. My name is Travis Franks, as was just told, and when I was asked to give a speech here at Mr. CCH, only one thing felt proper, felt correct, and that was to tell you a story, about a hard time. I'm sure we can all relate to that, something that a situation that was uncomfortable, a situation that I was new in, and it was really hard. So I hope this helps anyone to feel motivated, feel inspired. So here we go. I hopped off that plane at LAX with just a dream and a cardigan. Welcome to the land of fame excess. Woo! Am I gonna fit in? I hopped in that cab and it hit me. Here I am for the first time. I look to my right and I see that Hollywood sign. I mean, it hit me. This is all so crazy, you know? Everyone here seems so famous. And then my tummy started turning and I started to feel sort of homesick. I was under a lot of pressure and I got really, really nervous. But then, that taxi man, he did something. He did something that forever changed the course of history entirely. Not just my life, human history. He turned on that radio. And you want to know what was on? Do you want to know? A Britney song was on. Yeah, a Britney song was on. And in case you didn't hear it the first two times, a Britney song was on. So I put my hands up. They're playing my song. And the butterflies, they fly away. I start nodding my head like, yeah. Start moving my hips like, yeah, okay. So I put my hands up. They're playing my song. And here's the kicker. I knew in that moment that everything is gonna be okay. Yay, yay, yay. Yay, 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 yay. It's a party in the USA. And I'll close with this. Yay, yay, yay. Yay, 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 yay. It's a party in the USA. Thank you.
Give it up for Mr. Dream in a Cardigan. Yesterday was Veterans Day, but somehow this room, it still feels like it's a party in the USA. Our next contestant is Jay Grant. He's a freshman with a business major from St. Louis, Missouri, and he is Mr. Nervous. So let's see what that's about. Hey, I don't have your talent. Can you tell me what it is?
I sing. I can sing.
Oh, okay.
We'll be right back.
tequila.
Song.
No kidding. No kidding. Well, I hope he gets the help that he needs back there, since Anna couldn't give him the help that he needed up here. We'll go ahead.
We're roasting the contestants, not each other.
Oh, sorry. We're going to go ahead and move on to our next suspect for this afternoon. It's Grayson Janesco. He's a freshman from Jefferson City, Missouri, and is a med lab technician. Let's go ahead and introduce to the stage Mr. Wheezy.
Real, oh, oh. Real big breaths, so we're gonna go for this. Okay, okay. That's the first part, that's the first part. That should be good. All right. All right. All right. Ah! I brought backups. All right. This one's gonna take a real big breath. You gotta get the right amount of air. All right, that's probably good. All right. Second time's the charm, right? That's what they always say. It's not the third time, it's the second time. I hope it's the second time. All right, all right. We're gonna do a little dog today. All right, so we've got the tail and the legs there. Yeah, yeah, okay. And then we've got the front tail, the front legs. And now, all We've got a dog. Okay. All right, now we're gonna do a sword. Okay, just like the last one. All right. Okay.
These contestants aren't built like last year's Mr. CCH contestants. They just can't hang.
You're right, they cannot. Want to hear a joke about a balloon?
Is it funny?
I think so.
Okay, fine.
Oh, wait, it just got away from me.
Are you kidding? I don't get it.
Okay, what did one balloon say to the doctor? I feel lightheaded. How do you cure a sick balloon?
I don't know.
You helium up. I hope they're healing them both up back there because they need some help.
You got to get better jokes next time.
I'm sorry. I thought we weren't roasting each other.
Okay, my bad. I'm sorry. Do you forgive me?
Yes.
Okay. Okay. Our next contestant is Thomas McCauley. He's a freshman with a civil engineering major from Wardsville, Missouri. Mr. Red Nose. Hopefully he's not sick.
Hello, everybody. As maybe you saw with the snow this morning, Christmas is coming a little bit early, and Rudolph's coming to town. So if you know the words or the responses, please join in.
November 12th, the opening day of deer season, and we're already listening to Christmas music?
Yes, we're already listening to Christmas music. It was snowing outside, and have you been to Hobby Lobby? Because all of their Christmas stuff is out right now.
They have Christmas out year-round.
Well, if you go right now, they're playing Christmas music, and it'll get you all jollied up, because right now you're being grumpy. Bah humbug.
I'm sorry, it's not Christmas time, it's Thanksgiving time. Let's go ahead and introduce our next agent for this afternoon. Josh Pridemore is a sophomore biomedical engineering major from Ashland, Missouri. Let's go ahead and welcome to the stage Mr. Funky Frat Fighter.
All right, guys, so for my talent today, I thought I would talk about something that is a little bit annoying to a lot of people that live at CCH. And no, I'm not talking about the 4 a.m. fire alarms, although those are a lot of fun. I'm actually talking about frat guys. So, of course, CCH is right on East Campus, and so it's around some of the frats. And so most people at CCH have pretty frequent run-ins with frat guys. And some of those are good, and some of those are less than good. So I'm gonna give you guys, and especially you girls, some tips to maybe discourage the bad run-ins in the future. So for those of you who might not know what I'm talking about when I say frat guy, there's a stereotype. And so I have this picture that I think illustrates it pretty well. Where'd it go? Oh, there we go. Yeah, okay. So this is the kind of guy you want to avoid at all costs. You can note the Cardinals cap. I guarantee he doesn't know more than three players on the team. He just thinks it makes it look cool. And just the arrogance, the holier-than-thou attitude as he literally looks down on you. So, yeah, not a good guy right here. Yeah. And so I'm just going to give you guys some tactics to avoid having to mess with guys like that. So this first one is really simple, really basic. So everybody knows frat guys like to party, and so we're just going to distract them with that. And to illustrate this, I'm going to welcome out my frat guy, Gabby. Yeah. Give her a round of applause. Isn't she? Yeah. There we go. All right, so yeah, we're just gonna run through a little scene real quick, and I'm gonna be a CCH girl, in case you guys couldn't tell, I'm just like one, so, yeah.
How you doing? Hey, you know, if you were president, you'd be Abraham Lincoln, ayo!
Oh my goodness, wasn't that original? You know what? I heard there's a party that's like 50 miles that way, walking distance, if you're interested.
Yeah.
Wait. But it's only for people with face tattoos.
A face tattoo?
Yeah, you might be out of luck. Sorry.
Well, I mean, I do have the Sharpie my mom gave me at the beginning of the school year. I don't go to class, so I've never used it. But
okay.
You can put one on my face.
Okay.
Yeah.
What do you want me to write?
How about your number?
Okay. Here we go. There we go.
Oh, sick. Yeah. I'll call you later.
Great.
Party!
Yeah. Okay, so like I said, really simple, really basic, and it's going to work most of the time, though. This second one is my personal favorite. So more background about frat guys. Just a general rule of thumb around them. It's best to show as little skin as possible just to keep them from, you know, going crazy. And, you know, Jesus said guys with that kind of problem are supposed to gouge their eyes out, but in case they're not feeling up to that for whatever reason, this is going to work as well, just to cover up all visible skin as quickly as possible. So first what you're going to do is you're going to take your double XL sweatshirt that I know everybody just carries around with them all the time, so I'm going to put that on real quick. The process every time, sorry. Okay, now I'm gonna bring Gabby back out and yeah, just watch and learn.
Did you miss me? You know, Josh, I like the new look, you know, but I gotta tell you, you look a little sick. And I don't mean in a good way, but I think you need some help. I think you need some vitamin me! He's gone. Oh well. Off to the party.
Yeah, so that one's definitely my favorite. And if any of you girls end up doing that, definitely let me know and take a video if possible. I want to know how stupid I just looked. But yeah. Okay, and then that brings me to my third one. Definitely the most effective. This is going to work every single time. So if you're going to remember any of them, remember this one. And luckily enough, I think it might come pretty naturally to some UCCH girls. So Gabby, you want to come back on out?
Hold the applause. I said hold. So you got a name, or can I just call you mine?
Oh my gosh, are you my future husband? I've been praying about you for so long. This is so exciting. Finally, oh my goodness, I hope you're ready to get married. I already have it planned. The wedding's next week. Here's your suit, right here. Take it. Oh my goodness, and I'm ready to start a family. I want 4 boys and 1 girl, small family. The boys are gonna be Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John. I know, I'm so original. And the girl's gonna be Grace, because we just don't have enough Graces in this world yet. Do we, CCH girls? Oh my goodness, I wanna meet your parents. When do you wanna meet my parents? Wait, no, stop, come back. I want love, I want commitment. No. Thank you, guys.
I feel like we got called out.
Thanks, Anna.
I mean, not me, but you.
I know we've all heard, you know, the meet your spouse at campus house joke. And between Josh and our next suspect, Carson Rhine, a freshman from Imperial, Missouri, studying education today, starring as Mr. Marriage Counselor, I think they can help us out. Let's go ahead and welcome to the stage Mr. Marriage Counselor.
Yep. What's up, guys? For my act, talent, you know, whatever thing, I'm going to be giving you guys some relationship advice, because I know what you're thinking. What is this guy up here giving me relationship advice? And I'm not going to answer that question. So anyway, this stuff seems like common sense, but as a lot of you guys ladies know, guys really don't really have any of that. So just listen up, guys. For all I know, this might save your marriage someday. So here we go. Honey, have you gained some weight in your rearing? That dress you wear reminds me of my old girlfriend. Where'd you get those shoes? I think they're really pretty lame. Would you stop talking, 'cause I'm trying to watch the game. If you're a man who wants to live a long and happy life, these are things you don't say to your wife. I planned a hunting trip next week on your birthday. I didn't ask you 'cause I knew it'd be okay. Go cook some dinner while I watch this fishing show. I taped it over our old wedding video. If you're a man who wants to live a long and happy life, these are the things you don't say to your wife. Your cooking is okay, but not like mother makes. The diamond in the ring I bought you is a fake. Your eyes look puffy, dear, are you feeling ill? Happy anniversary, I bought you a treadmill. If you're a man who wants to live a long and happy life, these are things you don't say to your wife. If you're a man who doesn't want to get killed with a knife, these are things you don't say to your wife.
For all of those in need, he'll be taking appointments shortly.
Contestant is Anderson Rogers. He is a junior studying law from Bethany, Missouri, starring as Legally Brunette.
Hello, everyone. I don't know who that was. My name is Mr. Rogers, though. Unfortunately, I had to start studying this semester. And so I decided that I wouldn't have time to put together a show, but I decided to make a video. So today we get to watch a video together. Isn't that fun?
I walk through the doorway of the law school entrance, I take a look at my time and realize I got none left. Cause I've been reading and writing so long that even my roommate thinks that my mind is gone. I ain't never read a book that didn't deserve it. For me to have a social life, you know that's unheard of. I better watch how I'm talking and where I'm walking, or me and my homework might be lying in chalk. I really hate to dip, but I gotta go. As I leave, I see myself in the front row. Fool, I'm the kind of need a little homie when I feel like on my knees in the night, reading jorts in the dim light.
And spend most of my time living in law school paradise. Forgot how to exercise living in a law school paradise. It's hard work and sacrifice living in a law school paradise. I just need some life advice living in a law school paradise.
Look at the situation that got me facing. I can't live a normal life. I was raised to compete, so I gotta read down to the book scene. Too much dictionary searching got me chasing dreams. I'm an educated fool with funny on my mind. Got my pen in my hand and a gleam in my eye. I ain't never gonna sweat, I'm the new teacher's pet. Got my registration, I'm legally brunette. Fool, help ain't nothing but a hallway away. I'm studying, do or die. What can I say? I'm reading free now. Will I keep reading free more? The way things is going, I don't know.
Tell me, why are these so hard to read? And the books that are free are the ones we need. Been spending most of my time living in a law school paradise. Eating beans and refried rice, living in a law school paradise. I've only cried once or twice, living in a law school paradise. We're working days and reading nights, living in a law school paradise.
Read a book on Monday, made me kind of sour. Minute after minute, hour after hour, everybody's reading, but half of them are thinking. I don't waste my time with Lincoln. Of that, they've got no inkling. He says I gotta learn, but he ain't here to teach me. If he can't understand it, how can he reach me? I guess he can't, I guess he won't, I guess they front. That's why I know my time goes too fast, fool.
Been spending most of my time living in a law school paradise. Turn the page and roll the dice, living in a law school paradise. At least now I know my rights, living in a law school paradise. Well, I guess that will suffice, living in a law school paradise. Tell me, why are these so hard to read? And the books that are free are the ones.
That law school paradise, or that, whatever you call it.
That does not look like paradise to me. Okay, for our last contestant, and last but not least, we have Blake Retchin from Lynn Creek, Missouri, majoring in education, a 5'7.5", a pure pizzazz, weighing in at 135 pounds, Mr. Fun Size!
I just want to say real quick, this one right here. This goes out to all you short kings out there. There is hope, all right? Let's do this.
Thank you.
That concludes the talent portion of this evening, and we are about to transition into a time of intermission.
During intermission, we will have the People's Choice Award, or Mr. People's Choice Award. In the lobby, there's a table with suspects. Each bag has a picture and a name on it. That is where you will cast your vote for them to win Mr. People's Choice Award. And to win that, it's money donations. So the candidate that has the largest donation will win People's Choice.
I'm going to be welcoming to the stage Mr. Lance Tamarius. He's our director here at CCH, and he's going to introduce our mission for tonight.
Thank you guys for being here, and apologies to two groups of people. One, I know this is the opening day of deer season, and so apologies to deer hunters, and probably even more important to apologize to the women who were looking forward to time alone. And we tried to get the university to cancel the football game last week when we normally would do this, but we were not successful. Mr. CCH is many things, and it's a time, an excuse for families to come together. It's also a time for the students to show their creativity and to allow the guys to perform, and they're all extremely talented. Some have fun with the time that they could otherwise be showing talent. But they all are extremely creative and talented people, and together we're doing this to raise money for a mission. Mr. CCH began several years ago when we were looking for a way to get a staff member who was going to the mission field to Africa, he and his family of six. So some very creative girls had this dream, and the money was raised to help them get to their first trip in Africa, and we've been doing it ever since to raise money for missions. And deep into the heart of the campus house is a desire not only for all people to know Jesus, but for students to perhaps experience the call of God to where they might be needed. We are raising money this year for a mission in Central Asia, and the person that we're raising the money for, her name is Joy Martin. Joy came here from a wonderful family and a very God-loving family, but a few mission trips into her time in college, she discovered what it was that God had placed on her heart to do and where to go. And so we're going to watch a video from Joy talking about the opportunity we have to help her teach English, but more importantly, teach the scriptures to people in Central Asia. So if you will watch this, and at the conclusion of the video that she has sent us, there will be an intermission time in the lobby. So thank you very much.
Hello everyone, my name is Joy and I am from Columbia, Missouri. I'm a graduate of Mizzou. While I was a student and even after, I was very involved in the Christian Campus House ministry. I'm super thankful for all of the staff and leadership at CCH and how much of an impact they have been on my life. As a college student starting at Mizzou, my walk with Christ was not where it should have been, and I was just going through the motions in my faith. I was going to church and doing all the things that a Christian should be doing, but it wasn't real. I was just doing it because I had to do it, not because I really wanted to do it and serve the Lord. I started going to the Well my freshman year, and the staff and the students, one student in particular, just really took me in and under her wings and wanted to meet with me for coffee, and it changed my life. And after that, I had the chance to go on a mission trip with CCH. I went to St. Vincent to help at Wise Bible College. And because of that trip, God started to work in my heart and calling me to missions. After I went on that first trip to help at the Wise Bible College, I went two or three more times after that. I think I went three times total. And I had a wonderful experience, and I learned so much and was able to see more of just God's plan and purpose for me and how he wanted to use me. And so I taught elementary school in Colombia for 4 years, and then God called me overseas. I've been living here in Southeast Asia for 2 years now. I can't believe it. It's gone by so fast. But as I've been living here, God has given me an amazing opportunity to be a part of this ministry. I'm standing and filming this video today in the new English Corner Cafe. English Corner is a ministry that I've been able to be a part of since I moved here. English Corner was started by some friends of mine from the Philippines. They started it 4 years ago. And we meet every Saturday, and our purpose is to get together and to practice speaking English. But obviously our purpose and our goal is much more than that. It's to develop relationships and then to get to share the gospel with our students. So I have so many friends, so many local friends because of English Corner. It's been amazing to see how God has used this ministry to change so many lives. And then now that we have the opportunity to meet every Saturday, and not just every Saturday, but every day here in our own cafe. So every Saturday, we've been meeting for 2 hours every week, but we have to go to different cafes to meet different places. Sometimes we meet at cafes, sometimes at local schools, things like that. But now we have the opportunity to meet here in our cafe. And so it's just amazing to see how God has provided. There are still many more things that we need. And so that's the purpose of this video, is to share with you all just how English Corner is changing lives. English Corner is a ministry for college students, just like CCH. And just like CCH changed my life, English Corner is changing lives here. And so to be able to have this partnership between college students in the US and college students here in my city is full of college students, and English Corner is a ministry for them. And so our average age of student that comes to English Corner is anywhere between 18 to 22 years old. And so it would be so cool to see how CCH can partner with English Corner and helping us continue to grow this ministry and reach out to the college students here in my city. So I want to share with you a little bit more through pictures of just what English Corner is about. And then I want you to hear from my friend Lynn. She's going to share how English Corner changed her life, and then ways that you guys can partner and help us by giving to the mission of this cafe. Come on, knocking at my door today. I ain't gonna let it in. Child of God, on my worst day, I'm a child of God. Oh, every day is a good day, and you're the reason why. I'm so blessed, I'm so blessed. Got this heartbeat in my chest. No, it doesn't matter about the rest. If I got you, Lord, I'm so blessed. I'm so blessed, hallelujah, I'm blessed. I'm so blessed,
okay.
Hallelujah, I'm blessed.
And when I count the problems that I see, hope looks on but gone.
Lynn, why is it important that we have our own English Corner Cafe?
It's very important for us because it's been almost 4 or 5 years already that we have English Corner, but we don't have our own place. And we keep moving from different cafes, and some cafes do not welcome us anymore because our group is getting bigger and bigger. So some cafes, they not allow us to stay there, and we want privacy to share the good news, to share the good news. In special occasion for Christmas or Easter, we need a safe place for us to do this work. And I'm also really thankful for English Corner because English Corner is where I heard the good news and I became a Christian through this group. So I thank God that he's using this group to be a blessing to many students. They came to know Jesus, and some of them, they become a believer already. Praise the Lord for this group also.
About the rest. If I got you, Lord, I'm so blessed. Hey, I'm so blessed. I'm so blessed. Got this heartbeat in my chest.
And the cafe is almost finished now, but we still need things like a special machine, radio, books, paper, and chair, and materials for teaching. And please pray for us, pray for this cafe to be faster, and trying to finish it as fast as we can, and pray for us, and pray for the provision that we provide things for us to be done faster. Thanks.
Thank you for your prayers. Thank you for your financial support. Please feel free to reach out to me in any way if you have questions or you want to know more. I'm happy to connect with any of you and to get to share more of what God is doing. Thank you so much. God bless you all. Rajawai Poin.
Ideas, okay? We got crushed last quarter and we need to change something.
How about a focus group?
Not now, Hannah. We need real ideas.
We need to raise
money.
We need to spend less
money.
Can I get a visual for that?
Okay, so right now we're raising this much money, but we need to be raising this much money.
But what if we raise this much money with another 100?
You benefit a cause.
A great cause.
That's brilliant! A fundraiser!
A fundraiser!
We should make an event! We'll make all the residents help create it.
Yes! DIY.
Oh yes! People love DIY! Pinterest! No, wait, because we have to give them rules.
One rule.
But we keep it appropriate.
The boys.
The boys provide all the entertainment.
The boys will love it. And we will love it.
Okay, alright. Hold on. Girls are going to love this because what do what girls like to do?
Decorate.
Correct.
Seems a little sexist.
Shut up, Hannah! Okay, how do we get the boys to participate?
Got it. Two words. Talent show.
Talent show?
Talent show.
Talent show.
Talent show.
Talent show!
Yes!
Yes! Write that down!
Talent show. Talent show.
Hannah, write this down! Talent show!
Talent show.
Yes!
Yes!
Talent show! Okay, so while the girls are decorating and making sweets, the boys are in the International Center doing what?
Practicing the group dance.
Okay, but we can't just have a talent show. Okay, what else do we have?
We can call Lance and ask him for ideas.
Hannah, please! Let me call Royal Whittaker and see what he thinks. Hey, buddy.
Hey there, buddy.
What are your suggestions? Mr. Swag. Mr. People's Choice. Mr. Congeniality. Mr. Legit. What's that? What did mommy say? One winner. All right, that's it. That's all we need.
What about Mr. Swole?
No one likes exercise, Hannah!
This isn't a threat, Hannah!
No one's gonna think this is a real thing. It's too new. It's too different.
Yes!
Yes, 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 yes. Anything you can watch on America's Got Talent will have. Skits, comedy, danger, but all of it's a surprise. The only thing that's sure is that it's live. The only thing we need now is a name.
You know we could...
I don't know what you're going to say, but if the grown-ups are working here, and so I don't want you to say anything.
Mm-hmm.
What'd you say?
We're clear.
Mm-hmm. Mr. CCH! Great work, guys. Great job, Hannah. Excellent job. Really, appetizers on me. Let's go to Applebee's.
I think we'll make it before they close.
I really like Hannah. I think she has a lot of potential.
back, everybody, from intermission. It is now time for our formal wear part of Mr. CCH. So to start us off, we have
our first contestant, Mr. Bradley D. His talent is he can hear the second floor through any wall or ceiling. Wait a second, that's actually everybody. He's very good at sports, especially Wii bowling. Is creative, tech savvy, very good at sweet talking his parents into giving him money. Is known for throwing a disc really far, being tall, and semi-decent at rapping. A fun fact about him is that he won the fourth grade state basketball championship and has a six-pack, almost.
Emphasis on the almost. Pick a question, please. No, I have to read it. Amateur. How would you describe CCH to people you meet on campus that have never heard of it?
Oh, man. They're just my best friends ever. No, not really. Well, some of them, I guess. But no, they're honestly, there's some awesome people here. And I've been so blessed to, you know, come in as a freshman, just kind of a whole new college, whole new experience, and just have a bunch of people that love God and point me to God and help me grow in my faith. As well as doing fun stuff like this. So just an awesome community, and I'm super blessed to be here. So thank you.
Good answer, good answer. Next up, we have Mr. Full Send. With 21 years of experience under his belt and only 5 legitimate life-threatening incidents, James has done all right for a Calandro. Aside from hospital trips, he enjoys lots of hobbies and activities, especially those that provide adrenaline. A favorite pastime is mooching free food from campus events, activities, and clubs. He is proud of his ethnicity and is currently involved in the Society of Asian Scientists, Hispanic Engineers, Women in Engineering, and National Society of Black Engineers. These clubs all offer free food at their meetings.
Okay, Mr. Full Send, what made you want to be involved in CCH?
That's a great question.
You know, you wouldn't ask.
Probably this guy named Lance. He wears the best tank tops you've ever seen. And I don't know, every time I look at his tank top, I'm like, I aspire to be like that guy.
Our next contestant is Mr. Marvel. In his free time, he enjoys watching movies, playing video games, riding his bike, and cooking. His favorite color is blue. He swam competitively for 16 years before going to college and was born in Thailand. He enjoys listening to a wide variety of music genres and makes YouTube videos on occasion.
What is one piece of advice that you were given that has stayed with you?
One of the greatest pieces of advice that I've gotten is actually from Captain America, actually, and it is no matter what you do tomorrow, remember to remain who you are, not the perfect person, but a good man. And I feel like I've kept that up and I've helped, and that's really driven to who I am. And plus, Captain America is just super ripped and awesome.
Okay, good job, good job. Next up, we have Mr. Nothing, and there is nothing to tell. But for something, he participates in extreme philanthropy, which with many heroic acts, such as ensuring a sufficient number of video games are played daily, enough snacks are consumed, and raising the global average of time procrastinated. So, again, basically nothing.
What is your favorite thing about CCH and its community?
You know, I'm going to take a long break right here. to pretend like I'm thinking about a thoughtful answer. Then I'm gonna pretend like I did say something that was inspirational and amazing, and all of you are gonna say, wow. Thank you.
Our next contestant is Mr. Dream in a Cardigan. He was an actor for the Best Sight and Sound Theater presentation, Jonah, where he played a crab. He enjoys being absolutely terrible at golf and cheers for the Arkansas Razorbacks. Boo, pig.
Where do you see yourself 5 years from now?
Oh, absolutely. I mean, that's such an easy question. In severe poverty, probably. Paying off a lot of student loan debt. Not being able to afford anything, and probably living under a bridge. So, hope that was motivating for everyone today. Thank you.
Next up, we have Mr. Nervous. Just like the letter, but spelled differently. He is a business major, so pretty much undecided. One thing for sure is that he hates math because the Lord hates division.
Who is your spiritual role model and why?
Jesus.
Great answer.
I thought it was a cop out.
Our next contestant is Mr. Wheezy. Standing at a giant 7 foot, 5 inches tall, he is majoring in being a funny guy with a minor in med lab technician at Moberly Area Community College. He's mathematically minded with a teamwork outlook. Wait, this is not your job application, but he can do applied calculus.
If you could start a service ministry at CCH, what would it be?
I'm a pretty cleansly guy, and if I had to start a service ministry, it'd definitely be to clean the mold in the first floor bathroom.
Next up, we have Mr. Rednose. Thomas is bad at all the reindeer games like basketball and disc golf, which is why all of his friends laugh and call him names. He is hoping this year is his time to shine, or glow, to guide the sleigh on Christmas Eve and secure his crown as Mr. CCH.
What fruit of the Spirit do you feel like you produce the most and the least?
That's a hard one. I think the most, probably strawberries. And the least, I'm not much of a kiwi guy. Thank you.
Next up is Mr. Funky Frat Guy. Frat Fighter. My bad. He may only be 19 years old, but he's got worse hips than your grandpa, and for fun, he enjoys playing soccer, spending time with his friends, and procrastinating on homework. He was put on this earth to compete in pageants and play basketball, and he's too short to play basketball.
What is your favorite Bible verse or Bible story, and why?
My favorite Bible story is the story of Zacchaeus, because he's short just like me, and he inspires me that I can do stuff. Yeah, thank you.
Our next contestant is Mr. Marriage Counselor. He has the ability to make any conversation awkward. He's been saving marriages with music since 2022, is fluent in two languages, male and female, spends his weekends throwing discs into trees, and his newest client is an NFL quarterback going through a messy divorce. What is the most significant way you have grown in your time at CCH?
Well, not really much grown, but I've stayed the same height-wise, which is good. I'm like Blake. I think he's shrunk a little bit, so I know that was possible, but yeah, that's it.
Next up, we have Mr. Legally Brunette. His superpower is that he can jump slightly higher than the average white guy. Anderson lived at CCH last year, and of course that was back when he actually lived at all. Now he just studies and pretends to study. He is in his first year of law school, just trying to make sure it's not his last year in law school. Famous for bonking his head on the St. Louis Arch, he is mocked incessantly for being tall.
What is one piece of advice you would give to your high school self?
If anybody's wondering, those guys were great, but I brought this because I'm going to clean up shop with this. So with the high school self, so law school is fun, but also maybe pick something with a shorter degree next time. So.
And now, Mr. Fun Size. His car was stolen by a random guy. They reported it to the police, and then he found it himself. He is the third tallest of the Rechen family, including the girls. And in case you're wondering, there are five of them. Mr. Fun Size enjoys planting up like a tiger to support the subpar Mizzou football team, even on 30-degree days. What has been the greatest challenge of college so far?
Okay, so for me, I'm going to have to say trying to stay warm on 30-degree nights in the house gets really cold. Also, reaching the top shelf, that's a big difficulty for me. It's tough.
Thank you. Give it up one more time for all of our contestants.
We're going to go ahead and dismiss our judges at this time to go make their final calculations. At this time, we would also like to call back to the stage your 2021 Mr. CCH, Evan Miller.
Okay, guys, can I just get a round of applause for the wonderful warm-up performances we've had today? Thank you.
I'm glad you've kept your humbleness.
Now on to the main event.
We have some taxing questions for you, and we need the details, okay? What did being Mr. CCH mean to you?
Well, actually, I would like to say, first of all, that video that they showed at the beginning, okay, Robbie, where's Robbie at? Running around with a camera? He did that, okay? I told him, I said, you know, in the original James Bond film, that took like 100 people, like 6 months. It took one man like 3 weeks to do. So I don't think he got a lot of homework done, but can you
answer
the
question? Does he even have homework?
What?
Oh. No, I want you to answer the original question. Yeah, what did being Mr. CCH mean to you?
First and foremost, it was a humbling experience, to say the least. To me, I mean, it's quite a burden going everywhere, being known by everybody all the time. I mean, I've already got arthritis from signing autographs. I don't know. I go through about three things of chapstick a day because I have to kiss so many babies. My lips just get They get chapped, and it's not anybody could do it. Not anybody could do it, but I can. So,
how humble of you.
What piece of advice would you like to go ahead and pass on to the next Mr. CCH that will be crowned, you know, in a few minutes?
Sure thing. Well, if I could sum up my piece of advice in one word, it would be humility. And I say that because going into it, you know, they're going to see how good of a job I did in the last reign. And I don't want them to measure themselves up against that, you know? Like, they need to set the goal, set the stage for what they can do themselves. And I'm going to be really proud of them, and I'm going to be really supportive as retired Mr. CCH, just to make sure they don't feel pressured like they have to live up, you know, to what will probably go down as the greatest Mr. CCH reign of all time.
Probably, maybe. I have another question for you. Do you have any tips or tricks for handling all of that paparazzi and all the fame that you've had this past year that you'd want to give to the audience?
I mean, it's either built into you or it's not. Like, you're born with it, or you're not born with it. And so, I don't know if I really have.
Follow-up question, were you born into it?
100%.
Yeah. Are you sad about retirement? It's coming pretty soon.
I've actually gotten that question a lot. A lot of people ask me, they said, are you sad you can't compete this year? Are you sad you can't be Mr. CCH again? And I told them, that's a ridiculous question. Because really, retirement is more of an honor. And that's how I think about it. You know, the theme this year was Mission Impossible. I think mostly because it's going to be impossible to replace me. And so that's my answer.
Okay. And then can you tell the crowd about the responsibilities you've had as Mr. CCH and like what all it looks like and maybe even walk us through a day in your shoes?
Oh, boy, you guys got a lot of time to kill. So I wake up in the morning, and I do pee excellence. And then after I get that checked off the list, then I'm immediately hit with a crowd of people saying, how are you doing? What's going on? You know, trying to get to know my personal life. Writing op-eds about me, it's just part of the gig. And it's a humbling experience. Have I said that?
Like four times.
Oh.
We get it. You were Mr. Humble last year.
I was. What was the question again?
What like a day in your life is like, besides what you've already said.
So then I find some excuses to skip class, usually. Number one is trap shooting most of the time. Number two, it's hard to go outside sometimes because you can't make it to class with the amount of people who are blocking your way, trying to get your name, trying to get your autograph. I can't go anywhere on campus. I can't go anywhere, really, you know. I go up to South Dakota. I'm in the middle of nowhere. I'm going to run into somebody and say, hey, are you Mr. CCH? And I'm going to say, yeah, I am. And charge them $10 for an autograph, so.
How much money have you made off your autographs this year?
A lot. Definitely a lot. The charging idea just came to me now, sadly. So when I say a lot, what I really mean is not any. But they're going to be worth something after I'm dead, probably. So that's really an inheritance that I'm leaving.
What was your favorite part of being Mr. CCH?
My favorite part was that I could wake up in the morning and look in the mirror and say, you are Mr. CCH. And then the rest of my day was so easy because I knew I was awesome. I was gonna make it, you know?
So, do you think it was hard to stay humble after being crowned king?
It was unbelievably easy, actually. I mean, I didn't even have to put any effort in, really. I didn't have to. It came to me.
So what do you think of this year's competition, the boys? What do you think about them?
Give us the inside scoop.
The inside scoop. Well, they don't tell me anything anymore because I'm retired, I guess. They don't think I'm important. I don't know. I am, by the way. Most people think I am. But I mean, I think this year's contestants were phenomenal. They really were. Can we get a round of applause? Thank you. And really, with this year's contestants, I saw a lot of... They gathered a lot of things from me, I believe. And I really see the influence I was able to have in this position. And I just... It's a good thing. Because if I hadn't have influenced them, imagine what kind of Vankrit would have. You know, some of these frat boys that Josh was talking about, I mean, they're out there. And the fact that they could look up to somebody like me, you know, and I could lead them in being humble, wonderful human beings, like I am, you know, and here's the deal. We got to remember, they're trying, and that's what counts, okay? That's what's important.
Do you have any last or final words you'd like to leave the crowd, leave the boys, just anything as your last final words as Mr. CCH?
You act like I'm passing away or something. Well... I mean, I'm still going to be around, and I'm still going to be talking. So as far as my last words, just, you know, don't forget where you came from is probably my number one piece of advice. And I came from excellence, so I don't know where they came from, but I guess that depends on who wins.
Let's give it up for the 2021 Mr. CCH, Evan Miller.
Mr. Humble.
Of the pine, you know how I feel. It's a new dawn, it's a new day, it's a new life, it's a new life for me. And I'm feeling good. When I
The results are in, but first we would like to thank everybody who's been here and coming out tonight, and also all the people who put in the work to make this event possible. So we want to thank Gabby and Hannah and Sophia for being wonderful directors. So if you'll put your hands together for them. One more big round of applause for all of our contestants and all the help here tonight.
We also have the amount that we have raised. We are pleased to announce that we have raised $4,186.65. And that is not including any donations that were given through Venmo. So that is cash donations only. So $4,186 and counting.
Yeah, and the final amount will be announced on Facebook and Instagram when we post all this on social media. So first, without further ado, if I can have a drum roll, please.
Your 2022 Mr. Legit goes to Mr. Marriage Counselor.
Next, we have for Mr. People's Choice, Mr. Full Send.
Mr. Swag goes to Mr. Fun Size.
Next, we have Mr. Congeniality as Mr. Nervous. Now, for the moment you've all been waiting for, another drum roll, please.
Your 2022 Mr. CCH goes to Mr. Nothing.
Yusuf's gonna give us a bow. Give us a bow. An appropriate speech.
Well, if I could just say a word. I simply did not prepare for this at all.
Thank you, thank you. Yeah, let's give it up.
Okay, so that kind of concludes our program. One big round of applause at the end again, and then. We're gonna welcome Chris Crow back to the stage for some final announcements.
Yeah, let's give a big round of applause for Chris Crow.
So we've already done a lot of thank yous and congratulations. But I wanna add one big thank you to everybody who's here, everybody who came to join us tonight, not only for coming and watching and participating in all of this madness, but also for your financial donations going towards such a great cause. I know you guys heard that announcement of the total over $4,000, well over $1,000 more than the goal that we had originally set out to hit. And so that's incredible. So thank you guys. Thank you guys for that. Thank you guys for being a part of raising such a wonderful group of people, both the guys up here who are performing, the girls who all had a part in putting this together. It's through families like you guys that we are able to do what we do at CCH, why we're able to be successful in what we do, and why we're able to further the kingdom of God. So we want to thank you guys. I'm going to close us out with a quick word of prayer, and then we're going to be dismissed, and there will be a time for you guys to meet up with your students, maybe grab some pictures. There's a photo booth right out in the lobby that you can grab pictures at as well. Congratulate your students, and then we will be dismissed for the evening. So let's go ahead and close with a word of prayer. Father God, we thank you again for this opportunity, Lord, the fun and the joy that comes with celebrating our gifts and abilities and laughing with and at one another, Lord. Lord, we thank you for all the money that was raised, for all the people who came and supported such a great mission that's going to do great work in Southeast Asia and all across the world, Lord. Lord, let everyone be safe as they travel home. And most importantly, Lord, we thank you for the very reason why we gather here today to center ourselves around your gospel and your mission. We thank you for your grace and for the cross. That's in Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Let's get one more huge round of applause for everybody involved. And we will see you next year for Mr. CCH 2023. Have a great evening.